Do you want to be a video game maker but don't know how to code? Well, today you have options. Modern game engines have made it so that you can make hit games without knowing how to write a single line of code. In this video, we'll review the best engines for creating video games without having to do any programming. We'll also show you the types of games that these engines have created in the past. After watching this video, you will know how engines will allow you to create without coding, and which is best for your specific development goals. We've seen indie developers use these engines to create their own games with impressive levels of success. We've also heard from the Ask GameDev community on their preferred engine choices with our recent video on the best engines in 2018. Click here to check that video out. We are the Ask GameDev crew, aka the Unreal Slim Shadies, aka Get Shorty. And these are the best engines that don't require coding in 2018. Welcome back. If you're new to Ask GameDev, we make videos to help you learn about the games industry so that you can elevate your games and inspire others. If you're on a game dev journey, consider subscribing as our community works together through videos and comments to share insights and best practices that will help your game development. Before we get into naming the actual engines, let's talk about some game development basics. That way, you can better understand why it is indeed possible to make games, and not just basic games, great games, without knowing how to code. Let's start by thinking of games as building blocks. Games are made up of building blocks or objects. A game will have hundreds or even thousands of objects. A game engine will display these objects, but also do up to three more things based on the needs of the game designer. 1. The engine will give life to these objects by giving them attributes and characteristics. 2. The engine will allow these objects to interact with one another. And 3. The engine will allow these objects to interact with the user. To illustrate this concept, let's take a super basic example like a platformer. Let's use our favorite mascot, Super Teal Robot, as an example. If we look at the screen, we can see four objects. There is Super Teal Robot, a bad guy, more specifically a purple goon from the Rainbow Robots, the background, and the floor. As we just mentioned, a game engine will, where needed by the game designer, give attributes to objects, give them a set of rules on how they interact with each other, and give them a set of rules on how they interact with the player. Let's apply this concept to the four objects, one by one, and go from the most basic to the most complex. The background is the most basic. Its job is to just be the background. No physics, no interactions, it's just there. The floor has a physical attribute. Objects that touch it need to be able to stand on it. If it didn't have this attribute, objects would fall right through. The bad guy, like the floor, has a physical attribute. When the bad guy touches the floor, he stops. He also has some rules in place. For example, when he walks, a rule for him is that he has to play his walk animation. He also has rules regarding his interaction with Super Teal Robot, like attacking it. This might mean playing a different animation when he is near Super Teal Robot, and also modifying Super Teal Robot's health should his attack be successful. Super Teal Robot is the most complicated of the four. Like the bad guy, he also reacts to physics. One of his rules is to also play a walk animation when he walks, and there is also a set of rules built in him related to his interactions with other objects, like the bad guy. He probably also has attributes like health and ammunition that are linked to their own rules. The most unique thing about him, though, is that the player controls him. So he has a whole set of rules related to that. For example, when the player presses the A button on their controller, that might fire off a rule, like a jump action for Super Teal Robot. So, as you can see, it's all just a combination of objects, attributes, and rules. If you understand these core concepts, you can understand how and why it's possible for an engine to require no code at all. Because, what if an engine already had the freshly authored game code for telling objects how to react in the situations above? What if there were already built-in scripts for things like platforming, running, jumping, and fighting bad guys? And what if you can control all of these interactions using a simple interface and drag-and-drop commands? Well, that's exactly what's possible today with the engines that we're going to talk about in this video. It essentially works like this. 1. Take your object, say Super Teal Robot. 2. Find the rule you want, say jump. 3. Drag that rule from the rule box and drop it onto Super Teal Robot. 4. Tweak the values to your taste. And now, you've given your character the ability to jump without having to write a line of code. And with that, here are three engines that we recommend for making games without coding. Please note, for this list we tried to focus on engines where you could create a game from start to finish without having to write a script. There are other great engines that beginners should check out, like Godot and RPG Maker. However, users of those engines may benefit from having some coding background. This also isn't to say you won't be able to use an engine that requires coding. It's common for engines to have add-on scripts that make it possible to script visually. For example, Unity. There's an extension available in the Unity Asset Store called Playmaker that makes visual scripting possible. The indie title, The First Tree, was actually made using Playmaker. When it comes to add-ons, though, there are a lot, and some may be better than others, so it's best to do your homework. Now, on to the list. The first on the list is Construct 3. If you want an engine that does exactly what we mentioned above, look no further than Construct 3. With its drag-and-drop interface and its library of built-in rules, you can make a game like the Super Teal Robot example in no time. There are also great tutorials on YouTube for Construct 3. In fact, one of our favorite YouTube channels, Gigantic, has a great tutorial where they show you how to make a platforming game step-by-step using one of their asset packs and Construct 3. If you didn't know where or how to begin, this is exactly where we recommend you start. You can check out a link to their tutorials here. Construct 3 has a free trial available, and licenses start at $99 a year for a personal license. Some Construct games include 8-Bit Fiesta and Clang. Next is fan favorite GDevelop. GDevelop is an open source game engine designed to be used by everyone. No programming skills required. It has a drag and drop interface, built-in events, and tons of tutorials. When ready, you can export your games to iOS, Android, Mac, Linux, and even Facebook Messenger. The best part of GDevelop is its price. GDevelop is an open source project and is licensed under the MIT license, meaning you can use it for absolutely no cost. In terms of games made using GDevelop, you can check out and even play GDevelop made games right on their website showcase page. https://gdevelop-app.com/games-showcase. And last but not least is the classic Game Maker. Game Maker has been around for years and has developed a great community. You can find an endless amount of tutorials on YouTube, and you can even buy books on Game Maker. Its drag and drop interface does exactly what we mentioned in the example, and only if you choose to, you can do a few more things using their scripting language. The latest version, Game Maker Studio 2, starts at $39 for a basic license and goes all the way up to $1,500 for its Ultimate Edition. A free trial is also available. There are tons of Game Maker games, way too many hits to name. But recent and upcoming Game Maker made games include Nidhogg 2, Way of the Passive Fist, and Wandersong. And there you have it, three engines where you can drag and drop your way to a hit game. Let us know what you think is the best no-code game engine in the poll above. Thanks for watching. We are Ask GameDev, and we make videos on games, the game industry, and more. Let your fellow viewers know what engines we missed in the comments. Don't hold back. The viewer community needs your opinion. If you do like this video, the best thing you can do to help is to upvote the video or leave a comment. We publish new content every week on how to elevate your games, so consider subscribing. Hit the bell below to be notified as soon as a new video is available.